All right, everybody, let's continue on here. We're going to continue my franchise. So we're going to skip till, let's skip to the Houston Rockets here. So see what happens from now till then. Hopefully no big injuries. How's it going, T-Rock? We could really increase our attendance if we run a special promotion. All right. I don't know. Let's do family night. All right. Good. Now what's going to happen here? Mario Chalmers has now fully recovered. Awesome. We'll see where I can put him at. So, let's decrease maybe Mike Miller here. Well, actually, Mike Miller is one of my better guys, so... 10 minutes seems reasonable. Let's drop his... Michael Beasley... who else I can drop here? I think I should be good. I'll give him 19. Nah, 15 seems good. I'll give him 1 hour... 1 minute. And Michael Beasley. There we go. Alright. Yeah. Trade either. Marcus Thornton has a playable. No! Oh, man. That sucks. Well, Michael Kidd-Gilchrist is getting all them minutes. There we go. Michael Kidd-Gilchrist is in the lineup now. See if I can get Michael Kidd-Gilchrist playing well. Prospects, alright. Randy Taub, Blake Chandler, Joey Duncan. We got a couple of shooting guards. And a center. I kind of like the center. Good stuff. Scout some centers. We need some centers. Kind of like the sleepers, man. They're freaking awesome. But let's go second round. Alright. Now what's happening? Marcus Thornton. Oh, awesome. Yeah. Holy crap. Now I can put him back in. Well, actually, Kidd-Gilchrist is actually doing a bit better, actually. Crap, I'm going to put Michael Kidd-Gilchrist in there. Alright, good. Alright. Here we go, Houston Rockets.
And now, the 2K Sports pregame show. Brought to you by Sprite.
See what happens here.
I can't express how good it is to have you with us here on 2K Sports. I'm Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal. Tonight, it's the Houston Rockets as they'll be playing against the Denver Nuggets at Pepsi Center. Well, it was Denver in their last game with a loss to the Spurs in San Antonio. Nice job they've been doing over the last 10 games. 8 wins and not having too many problems. I like what I saw out of this kid at Arizona last year, and now he's in the NBA. Aaron Gordon, 6'9", 220, kind of a tweener.
Yes, he is a tweener, even though he's worked to improve his shooting so he could play the three. But the way the league is going, Ernie, he's probably best at power forward.
He's got the same standing reach as Blake Griffin.
He can defend power forwards, and he will continue to add muscle.
All right, thank you, Shaq. That's wonderful. Wonderful insight. I just can't say that enough to you. Kevin Harlan, take it away.
All right. Let's get this show on the road. The Rockets. I'm wondering what my record is.
Let's be Joe. Denver Nuggets starting lineup. In the middle. 16, 10.
All right, let's go.
Let's
Mikhail Chris is finally in, starting. Hopefully he doesn't screw up like that one game. Last game he didn't perform good.
This is Kevin Harlan. And the Nuggets on friendly ground as they continue this homestand. All right. They're one of the most dangerous teams in the NBA right now. No question, they've won 7 of their last 8.
Well, I think for Denver, they've actually taken the NBA by storm since the season kicked off. They put themselves right in the mix with the league's top teams when most people thought they'd be.
It's like the only one who gets old, but he can't seem to drop from that.
I think they'll be in that mix all the way to the end.
Here's the starting group for Houston. They've got Green. Bismack Biyombo is out there with Gordon. And there's Klay Thompson. And it's Wall in at the one. Now, here's Green. Just 3 to shoot. Back to Wall. From deep 3-point range. Can't get it to go.
Nice. Go, go, go.
For the Houston Rockets, they come in off the loss to the Nuggets.
Yeah, given how they performed offensively that day, guys, they really had no chance.
Yeah, and the frustration just mounted. You could see it as they continued to come up empty.
Kawhi Leonard, baby.
Just happy to get out of there and have the game be over. How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
Isaiah Thomas is listed at 5'9", but I think he may be a shade smaller than that. Regardless, he's got a strong frame for his size. He knows how to use it. He shot 6 free throws a game last year because he understands how to get into defenders, and he can play through contact. And he's automatic at the line, well over an 80% free throw shooter.
Thompson misses.
Yes.
Well, that's clearly a situation you want to make sure you don't give him too good of a look at.
Well, true. The defenders shouldn't relax just because he missed that one. He's capable of getting hot in a hurry.
Now, here's Thomas. 20 points for him last game against San Antonio.
Ah, crap. You jerk.
Duncan right side. The Nuggets need to get a shot off here.
And Kawhi Leonard! Yeah!
And Thomas is so elusive. A lefty. That's always Stephen Edge.
Yeah, he loves to operate.
Yeah, baby.
And, you know, coming Leonard through the lane with
knocked
that
lefty. Knocked him down already. Nice.
And he's got that good pull-up jumper as well, so he's a tough cover.
And here is Green. Kawhi Leonard getting his 3 to go. Shot is good.
Right back at you. They immediately get those 3 points back.
Trading punches. That's how you answer.
Leonard on the wing. Left side, Leonard. Left side, Leonard.
Passer.
Up top, Kid Gilchrist. Outside for Thomas.
Oh.
That'll be dangerous as it goes on a bounce. Nuggets retain possession.
Well, I had a chance to check out some stats for John Wall. Last 10 games for him have been excellent, averaging about 19 points, 7 assists, and 5 rebounds.
Duncan.
And just look at those scoring totals. He's been doing what he does best, putting points on the board.
Yeah, how valuable player
I'll get that rebound. Nice.
Scores are always valuable. It gives them such a reliable option.
Ah!
Boy, we don't see that too often.
God,
no defender on him, and he just clanks the open jumper.
Into Green. And Leonard with the block. Biyombo
kicks
the
ball. Flew right back at him.
Feeds it to Thompson.
Let's go.
Green dishes to Thompson.
Oh, yeah. Go, go, go.
Kid Gilchrist with it. Picked up by Thompson.
And yeah.
Gets it to go.
That's how to orchestrate for your teammate. Terrific pass.
Nice.
Rockets trail by 5.
Well, some of the faces changed both on the floor and on the sideline for Denver last year, but they were still able to get up and down the floor for a lot of points.
And that one's good.
Dang it.
Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Thomas against Wall. Now here's Duncan. He's guarded closely. No luck.
No! With the Timmy! Timmy freaking missed it! God dang it, Timmy!
Possession. Chris Anderson is checked in for Wright. Beasley comes in for Tim Duncan. And it's Thornton in for Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And the Rockets making a
no, I did not want to shoot that. Dang it.
I'm not sure about that shot. Defense really all over.
For the Nuggets, Miller comes in for Leonard. And it's Chalmers in for Isaiah Thomas. Thompson passes to Walt. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2.
It's the wall.
John Wall at 6'4", 39-inch vertical leap, and long arms.
Yes.
He's an elite physical specimen when it comes to the point guard position.
Jeremy Lamb's checked in for Klay Thompson. Now, here's Chalmers, averaging 6 points per contest.
Dang it, he didn't pass the freaking ball.
Marcus Thornton on the wing.
Look at him. Dang it.
Shot clock at 6. It's Beasley on the wing.
Come on, get that. Ah! Right oh, wait. Ball, what the freak?
Open court, perhaps. Steve Prince, the fastest player in the league end to end. He is devastating in transition.
Yeah, he's so tough to stop around the rim, even in the half court. But when he gets ahead of steam going, he can get into the lane and then finish with either hand. So, man, he is tough to stop.
Now here's Beasley, following the miss by Aaron Gordon. Beasley outside.
Man, come on. I didn't want to pass to him. Come on. Passing is awful in freaking this game. In last game.
And 101 left in the first quarter of the game.
Oh, my God. Really?
Biombo's got his first bucket in this one. Denver's gone 2 or 3 from deep so far in this game. Chalmers dishes to Miller. Miller, right side. He feeds it to Thornton. 6 on the shot clock. They need this one, and he sinks the layup. Thornton's got his first 2 points of the night.
I'll tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Outside, Wall. Pass to Lamb for 3. Chris
that
Anderson pulls it in.
Area.
Denver in the lead. Miller kicks to Chalmers. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot 2. It's going to be on John Wall.
And the offense just getting right to the rim, but at least they saved the layup with the foul. That's old school basketball rules. I mean, at the end of the day, no easy layup. Earn it from the line.
Denver shooting their first free throws tonight.
Dang.
The first trip to the stripe in this one. He hits the second from the line. Seven seconds left in the first quarter. Here's Lamb. And the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target. So at the end of one quarter of play, still a close.
All right, let's go.
Welcome back, folks. We have a close game here at the start of the second quarter of play. And when you consider how Denver is doing, Steve and Clark, what are your thoughts?
Yeah, the defense has been terrific. They came out right from the beginning alert and focused, and they've been really good at that end of the floor. And I think Coach has to be pleased with the effort, Steve.
We've got Thornton. Kawhi Leonard is out there with Kyle O'Quinn. That's Brandon Wright, and it's Thomas in at the point guard. That's the group on the floor for Denver. Now, here's Thornton. He just could not put it together in that loss to San Antonio.
Well, the pick worked really well there. Nice job taking it right to the 10 for the layup.
Rockets trail by 4. The feed to Green. The shot by Thompson, and no one's around.
Dang.
Gets it to go from 18 feet away. Thompson's got 5. Thompson's gone 2 of 3 from the field.
Well, kind of an interesting paradox for Jeff Green. He's much better offensively playing at the power forward spot as a spread 4, but defensively he's much better guarding 3.
No!
Stolen by Green.
Piece of crap.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Doris Papers.
Well, Kevin, Klay Thompson is already an elite shooter, but he isn't done yet. He wants to be a complete off-guard.
Dang
he
it.
Said, I'm trying to attack more. Everyone knows my jumper is the base of my game, but to be an all-star caliber player one day, I have to finish at the rim. I have to dunk more, show people I can jump. Guys?
He keeps adding layers to his game. Thank you, Doris. And Jeff Green, not a big rebounder, struggles guarding in the low block. What do you think Clark is his best position?
You know, it's hard for me to say, Kevin. I think he's probably just a 3/4. I think at the 4 he has a little bit more of a quickness advantage. So I would probably look to playing him at that position.
Shots good by Rice.
And he came off that screen. The defense just couldn't get over the top.
Correct,
beautiful play.
Man. The key.
Yep, and without a hand in his face, he's going to bury those.
Now, here's Thomas. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Leonard kicks to O'Quinn. Kicks it out to Leonard. 4 on the shot clock. Thomas, it's a wide open look. Another
nice.
For Denver.
You can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
So for the Nuggets, their last game, a loss to the San Antonio Spurs.
Come on.
Yeah, they
can't
really
let them score
from
this.
The field.
Come on.
Credit the defense, definitely, but even when they got open looks, they were not hitting.
Hey, Steve, me and you flub up words and misstate things on occasion. So do these players have bad nights. It happens.
All right. Come on.
Now, here's Green. Last time, 14 points.
Nice. Go, go, go.
Pass to Thornton. The dish to Leonard. Thompson comes with the double team. Passes it to Thomas. 6 to shoot. Outside for Thornton. And it's Biombo with the rebound. Biombo's got 3 rebounds now in this one. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Here's Hudrick.
No!
Averaging 6 points per contest. Good on that shot. And with that, the Nugget lead is cut down to 1 on the bucket from Thompson. Timeout is called. First of the game for the Nuggets. They won the last game against the Rockets in Houston.
Now, the last meeting was a successful one. They were very sharp defensively, causing a lot of turnovers, and that swayed the game in their favor.
Here's what Denver's going with right now. Chris Anderson has checked in for Wright. Duncan comes in for Kyle O'Quinn. And it's Kid Gilchrist in for Marcus Thornton. Nobody near Kid Gilchrist.
Come on, Kid Gilchrist. You're going to make that,
and
man.
That one is good with the extra effort on the glass. Duncan's
good job.
Got
good
his
thing we had
freaking
Timmy under there.
Duncan's trailed by 3. What an easy win for him last time. As Steve mentioned, Clark, the turnover differential was a major factor.
Yeah, I called it disruptive in a word from the defensive standpoint. They were all over him the whole game.
Come on, get that. Yeah.
A shot that he sometimes struggles with, but you can't fault him for taking it when the defense backs off like that.
Duncan, the pass to Leonard. Thomas, it's a wide open look.
Oh, he missed. Well, come on, why are you missing freaking wide open looks? Come on, man. My freaking guys are missing wide open shots.
Yep, right to the
rack. Crap, man.
Denver's gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Kicks it to Kid Gilchrist. Dishes to Duncan. Duncan right side. Nobody near Leonard. That's
there we
so
go.
With the
why Leonard's only one can make the open shot right
there.
Now.
He played the role of the maestro on that one.
And now the first timeout called here for the Rockets.
Well, playing in the West can be a grind, and that's what was impressive about where the Rockets ended up. They didn't rely on their bench a whole lot. They really rode their starters.
Catching up on the changes for Denver. Michael Beasley, he's checked in for Duncan. Miller comes in for Leonard. Chalmers in for Thomas. Houston also making some changes. Mike Dunleavy, he's checked in for Green. And Jeremy Lamb subbed in for Thompson. As you said, Clark, Rockets did well against the rest of the conference and really didn't have a deep rotation.
Usually that can catch up to a team, but the Rockets starters were able to stay healthy and log big minutes last year, and it's why they nabbed that 4th seed in the West.
And Wall kicks to Lamb. Gordon dishes to Wall. He nails it.
Really? Come on.
Nice pass there to set that bucket up.
Yeah, guys, and that's 10 of their last 12 points now coming off of assists.
Beasley outside. There's 25 seconds left in the first half.
Just
gets it to go in.
That's far too good a look to give them from behind the arc.
Well, that's 3 of the last 5 makes, having been behind the 3-point line. So, got to make some adjustments defensively.
Gordon with the screen for Wall.
Come on.
Almost,
there
but it rolls out. And here's Anderson. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. He got it up.
There we go. Nice. Yeah. There we go. Thanks for talking about Anderson.
Maximizing every last possession you've got.
Second quarter ends in a tight one.
Yeah.
The Nuggets on top.
There we go.
And now a
Leonard has my most points.
Welcome back, everyone. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far.
Too
for the Rockets, they really struggled against Leonard.
He stings up.
He has 11 points.
Let's
go. He's got 9 points from behind the arc.
That has
been an important part of his game today. He's made his open looks.
All right, here we go.
Rockets trail by 5. And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball.
Right.
So on the floor for Houston.
Green is out there with Gordon. John Wall.
Then it's Thompson. Go. Then it's Wall.
No.
Biombo at the 5, roaming the paint. Down to 5 on the shot clock.
Come on.
It's Thompson off the drive. And there's the call.
Charging foul. Nice.
His first foul of the game.
That's the way you play defense. He saw the hop step a mile away and got in the path to disrupt it.
Thomas kicks to Leonard. Duncan with a screen on Green. Leonard the pass to Duncan. He used that
nice
to perfection. Duncan's got the first points of the third quarter up on the board for Denver. And for Houston, they're shooting well. 50% from the floor.
Big lead now. Nice.
Well, Tim Duncan, when asked about his retirement plans right after the 2013 finals, refused to dignify the question with the response. But last season's
come on, no! Wait.
Gordon Thompson outside.
Oh! God dang it.
Back to Gordon. Poked loose.
Oh, go, go, go.
Duncan. All going up court.
Boom. Yes.
Tore it down that time.
Why Leonard, baby.
And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game right now.
Clark, there is a spider out here on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either.
That's right. Those are phenomenal dunks to watch. So much
from the sideline. Let's catch up with Doris Burke.
Well, guys, this summer the Rockets lost a pair of Chiefs, Jeremy Lin and Chandler Parsons, but failed to add a
big
name free agent.
Miss this ball.
Coach Kevin McHale admitted. We had a disappointing free agency, to be honest with you. We'll have flexibility next year, but flexibility doesn't score. You don't like to lose talent. That's always a tough save. Guys?
We'll see how they bounce back.
Oh, my God, they're all...
There's the pass to Kid Gilchrist. Leonard attacking. He kicks to Duncan.
Nice. Timmy! Freaking Timmy!
Those are the possessions they can build on and begin to pull away here.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time getting the lid off the basket so far.
All with it, averaging 19 points per contest. He dishes it to Thomas.
Yes, got it. Get the ball.
Leonard kicks to Kid Gilchrist.
Boom.
And now an 11-point Nugget lead.
Another good pass.
Yeah,
and their offensive execution has been impressive, to say the least.
Again,
have been assisted. Yeah, passing has kept the defense off balance, but to get assist, you got to make the shots.
And the Nuggets making a change here. Thornton's checked in.
Got it.
And
yeah.
For so long,
go.
Their home court advantage is so tough at home normally, but not last season.
And the altitude factor has only been a
Timmy.
Shots in the Nuggets really having trouble finding the bottom of the net.
Boy, what a nice third quarter surge they've got going on right now.
You know, Steve, never a better time than the third quarter in my mind to get the momentum going your way.
Gordon with a screen on Thomas. It's Wall with the drive. Here's Gordon.
uses the bonus to finish the layup.
You lucky.
Gordon's got 4 points in the quarter.
Finally get one to drop after starting the half with four straight clanks.
Leonard on the wing. Thompson comes with the double team. Leonard kicks to Thornton. Here's the three.
No!
With the rebound.
Oh, Timmy!
Gordon's got
Freaking Timmy again.
Used to having an outstanding home record due to the altitude adjustment. Last year, only 21 home wins. Not great at all for them.
The drive by Green at the top of the key. Gordon back to Green. Feeds it to Wall. Pocket six. They set the screen. Off the pick.
Oh! Oh!
Tore it down that time.
Nice.
Boy, that's some physical basketball out there. I'm glad I'm not in the middle of that. A hard pick and an assault on the bucket.
Old school stuff there.
All right.
There's a lot to like on that play.
Chris Anderson has checked in for Tim Duncan. Mike Dunleavy, who's checked in for Houston. Rudrick comes in for John Wall. They double him with Green. Right down low. Defended by Green.
Dang, I can't.
Here's Thornton.
Oh!
Second shot opportunity.
Anderson.
And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
That's obvious foul. Yeah, he took a hit right there and earned his free throw.
Dang it,
Let's
Chris.
Take a moment here to get That's your right. guys' take on scoring so far for the Nuggets.
There we go.
And they keep piling up the assists.
At least he's sunk one.
Great ball movement.
They've consistently drilled the mid-range jumper tonight as well, which has forced the D to come out on.
Michael Beasley, he's checked in for the Nuggets. Chalmers comes in for Thomas. Here's Green. Chris Anderson pulls it in. Anderson's got his fifth rebound in this one.
He's given them little to nothing at the offensive end.
Boom!
I can't put it any other way.
His shooting has been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons his team is up in this game.
We've got 1:23 left here in the third quarter. Now here's Lamb. He's guarded by Thornton. No good from
Nice. Lamb.
And the rebounding numbers don't actually tell the whole story. I mean, they're barely ahead in that category, but when they've needed them, they've gotten them, they've really battled hard.
It's their work on the glass, Steve, that's prevented any kind of momentum swing.
Kicks it out to Leonard.
Ah.
And a wide open look for Thornton.
Gets Boom!
The fall. Thornton's got five.
That shot becomes effortless for them when the D is so relaxed. They've got to get more intense.
All right.
Here's Hudrick, defended by Chalmers. Here's Green. The shot misses.
Nice.
Now
go.
The other way. They host the Clippers after this game. And that's the third of four straight played at home. It's
God dang it. Oh.
Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Back to Leonard. And there's the defensive 3 second call.
Oh, okay.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
And he's been a consistent shooter at the line for them this season, shooting about 78%.
Guys, he's slightly fallen off his pace from a year ago at the line, and those points from the stripe have been a little harder to come by.
Boom! Yeah.
The final, the purpose, guys, the big lead becoming bigger. I like the look in their eyes.
And it's on both ends that they've been controlling the action.
Here's Lamb. High shot from 10 feet out.
That's a nice Sonk job it. Of getting the ball in the paint and burying the shot. That's exactly how it's done.
Oh!
I tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
All right, big lead. Big freaking lead. Yes. All right. Finish this game off.
And a moment here to look back at our State Farm assist of the game.
Well, no question, this was going to be the winner. Just take a look at the expertise he shows on this pass. Perfectly timed and beautifully placed.
And so it looks like Denver will retain possession here.
Such a careless pass. You've got to keep your head in the game here.
They've got Thomas. Duncan is out there with Brandon Wright. Then there's Michael Kidd-Gilchrist, and it's Thornton in a shooting guard. That's the group on the floor for Denver. And so it's going to be a 3-second violation out there in the defense. Okay.
Shooting for Denver, Isaiah Thomas.
And the technical free throw is good.
Nice.
Isaiah Thomas, the last pick of the 2011 draft, number 60 overall. Normally a player in that role doesn't even make the team, but he had an outstanding rookie season and he's earned his minutes. He's become a
Jerk.
And here we go with Thompson running up the court. The fast break ends at the rim with a jam.
How about that nice 1-2 punch there, guys? Great defensive play, and of course, it leads to the great basket in transition.
Love the attacking style there, Steve.
Thomas dishes to Kidd-Gilchrist. The drive by Duncan. Back to Kidd-Gilchrist. Five to shoot. Can't get it to go. Rockets trail by 16. Thompson passes to Rice. Outside Wall. He feeds it to Thompson. That's good. Wall with the assist.
Thompson's killing me.
Wall's got his fourth assist in this one.
And Isaiah Thomas held down the starting point guard spot with the Kings for 3 years. They brought in a number of challengers at that point guard spot over the years. Aaron Brooks, Jimmer Fredette, Gravis Vasquez. Thomas kept
what the freak? Come on, man.
Play somewhere else.
Miller's checked in, and the Rockets making a change here as well. Jeff Green is checked in for Glenn Rice Jr. Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Guys, over that last break, I listened to Kevin McHale address his team. He got after them and told them to turn up the intensity, saying, we put ourselves in a corner, and now we've got to fight our way out. Show me what you have. Let's see if we've got what it takes, guys.
As well as Thomas played in Sacramento, they pursued trades for him. We seem to be looking for more of a defensive, pure point guard play.
Perhaps a case of looking at what a guy can't do instead of emphasizing what he can do. It seemed like the writing was on the wall that he'd end up somewhere else, but a nice four-year, $27 million contract on an up-and-coming team.
Yeah.
I would have to say he's got to be pretty satisfied with how it's all worked out for him.
Leonard, he's checked in for Denver. And Wall kicks to Green.
Oh.
Yeah, the defender draped all over.
Pretty plain and simple. Got him good there.
Yes.
And he knocks down the first one. Houston making a switch. Gordon's checked in.
Miss again.
So
yes.
One of two
there you
go. Strike.
You know, there's always a little hesitation with newly formed star-loaded teams. And you wondered if the Rockets would click early last year. They did. Ended up with the four seed.
That sucked. Stupid defenders.
Outside for Thomas. It's hauled in by Gordon's got his second value tonight.
Wide open.
Now Thomas defending. Here's Thompson. Fires the jumper from the
God
corner.
God dang it, Clay Thompson. Stop
Thompson's
freaking draining that.
In the quarter.
Rockets made it in as the fourth seed last year, but still couldn't find a way past Portland in the first round. It ended up falling to them in six games.
Duncan with a screen on Wall. Thomas goes in. Nobody near Kidd-Gilchrist. Not sure what he was thinking there.
Even though he isn't having the best of game from the floor, it hasn't seemed to hurt him.
Gordon kicks to Green.
Gilchrist. Not doing good
no
again.
No one near Wall as he lets it go.
Oh my God.
That makes it just a
serious
digit lead.
Really,
though,
really my guys have to start shooting bad now?
They fought back, but it just wasn't enough.
Yeah, they couldn't overcome that poor start, Kevin. They did fight back, and it looked like the game seven was on the way, but then Damian Lillard, with one of the great shots in NBA playoff history, closed things out in dramatic fashion.
Brought you right out of your chair, didn't
it? Oh, big time. That was a great, great shot he made.
Thompson dishes the Wall. That drops.
Oh my God.
Here, guys, how did they manage
that's
to get
frick.
So hot just when it looked like the game was over?
Well, I think they're a really strong-minded team. They didn't get frustrated. They stuck together, and now they've gotten a huge injection of energy in crunch time.
Gordon against Duncan.
Ah, oh, man.
Right down low. Nobody near Leonard.
Now no one can make a three.
Rockets trail by nine.
God dang it.
Outside Wall. Pass to Thompson. Back to Wall. Lays it up and in off the prettiest.
Freaking crack.
Wall's got seven now in this quarter.
We're seeing him bring that shooting percentage up now, guys. The first half was a struggle for him.
Thomas passes to Leonard. Duncan against Gordon. And close. Duncan.
Come on!
Here's Houston now. They're on a 14-3 run. And Thompson kicks to Wall. AT that time from Leonard.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Thompson comes with the double team. Leonard kicks to Duncan. Outside, Kidd-Gilchrist.
And again, holy freaking crap!
Rockets have gone 6 of 8 from the field.
Holy
so
crap, Kidd-Gilchrist. God, you get on pretty good the worst freaking streaks really out of them all. Holy crap.
Outside, Leonard. And there's the 3-second call, this one on the defense.
Who the freak are they keep getting that? Jeez.
And no good on the tentacles, so unable to pick
that one
up.
Oh my god.
There's 42 seconds left in the fourth quarter. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Easy call there. No question about that.
Come on, man. He's missed every one free throw.
And the second of two is good. That stretches their lead to 8. Now a timeout called by Houston. They're losing by 8. We've got 33 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Wall dishes to Green. Wall against Thomas. It's Wall with the drive. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact.
Come on,
and no question, he got bumped on that shot.
Definitely no room for discussion on that one.
Denver with a platoon swap here on the floor. The Rockets also changing it up. Festus Ezeli, he's jacked in for Biombo. And Rise Jr. comes in for Jeff Green. And Jeremy Lamb subbed in for Klay Thompson. And no good is the first free throw.
They all have different freaking motions.
White is checked in for
remember them all.
Duncan comes in for Kyle O'Quinn. Kawhi Leonard is checked in for Michael Beasley. And it's Kidd-Gilchrist in for Miller. Houston also making some changes. Biombo, he's checked in for Ezeli. Green comes in for Glenn Rice Jr. And it's Thompson in for Jeremy Lamb. Catching up on the changes for Denver. Chris Anderson is checked in for Wright. Kyle O'Quinn comes in for Duncan. And Mike Miller subbed in for Kawhi Leonard.
Yeah.
Here's Chalmers. So the Nuggets win it.
They barely scored any in that freaking quarter.
Will more than steal. They went out and got this one.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, Tim, what happened?
Well, Kawhi Leonard definitely shot the best. Tim Duncan, sort of. But he started freaking missing a couple of bullcrap. Marcus Thornton was one of my worst shooters. Gilchrist, probably my worst shooter. And, yeah. Kidd-Gilchrist, once again, was one of my worst shooters, of course. But Marcus Thornton didn't do much better. So, I'm probably keep Kidd-Gilchrist in there for now. Had more rebounds by one. But, alright, now that's that.